Good day, everybody, and welcome to Suite Talks with Ben. On today's Suite Talk, we're going to be looking at some of the basics of on-plan scheduling here within ConstructionSuite. So now, as we're looking at the Today screen, if we move over to the scheduling portion of ConstructionSuite, we'll see here that we have a very easy-to-read, very nice layout of some of the scheduling applications here within on-plan in ConstructionSuite. We see here up in the top right, we'll have our recent schedules. These are going to show any of the schedules that we have currently been working in, maybe ones that we have either recently created or even just recently modified. We can see the date that each of these files were modified, as well as the project that each of these schedules are related to. Directly to the left of that name, we'll also notice we have a check mark here signifying that each one of these schedules are actually the primary schedules for this given project. That primary status is going to mean that anytime you see any sort of scheduling information, either within the scheduled tasks that are showing up in your activities window, maybe even the scheduling information underneath the project details within the specific project, all that information is actually pulling specifically from one of these primary schedules. Beneath the recent schedules window here, we'll find all of our scheduling templates. These are going to be templates that either we have provided you with ourselves or maybe even some that you've created on your own. One of the huge benefits of ConstructionSuite is that you can take a full schedule that you have currently been working on, one that you have pulled all the way through completion, and turn around and use that same scheduling framework as a template for future projects. If we were to go into each one of these individual folders here, we'll see a number of the different schedule templates that we have as well. And for you to be able to very easily right-click, choose to edit that template. That way you can make any sort of changes or modifications that you would like reflected whenever you create a new schedule, or just quickly open one up to get started. From here, we could either open up a blank schedule, launch the scheduling wizard as well, which the scheduling wizard, much like any of the other wizards that we also have within ConstructionSuite, will also help give you a guide or a step-by-step process to creating a new schedule. We can go ahead and select a predefined schedule here, select one of our templates that we would like to use, input any sort of project information directly into the wizard, as well as set up any of our work days and holidays as well. By clicking Finish, we'll go ahead and generate this schedule directly from the framework that we have put in place here, as you can see. Now, this framework that we already had in place is going to already include some of the predecessor relationships and durations that we had already included from the original schedule, the one that we had already based this template off of. And we'll notice, though, that it still begins on today's date. So from the day that you first create this schedule, in which case it is July 8th, we'll see that from here on out, any sort of modification, anything like that, is going to start from this actual beginning date, the date that we created the schedule. We'll see here on the left-hand side, we have our task list, and on the right, we have our Gantt chart. Now, modifications to these individual groups or tasks can either be made directly here within the task list or can be made within the Gantt chart as well. If we knew that our site work here was going to take a total of 5 days as opposed to 1 day, we could put in 5 to signify 5 days, and we'll see that change has been modified here as well. In the same time, we could also going ahead and selecting this task, put our cursor over the edge of the task box there, and then click and drag it accordingly. We'll see that now the days have been updated here within the task list as well as the Gantt chart. In addition to adjusting the duration here, we certainly can shift the individual tasks themselves to be scheduled on different days. We could also make these changes here within the task list as well. In addition to editing these current tasks, by right-clicking, we certainly could go ahead and add new tasks, as well as adding new groups. Just like within our estimates here, our groups are going to include any of the tasks beneath them, much like the categories, whereas the tasks within the schedule are very similar to the subcategories within our estimates as well. We'll see here that we do have a group, job site facilities, and the corresponding tasks or subgroups, if you will, beneath these as well. All the information that is included within the group here, specifically with the start date, end date, and duration, are pulling directly from the corresponding information of the task beneath it. And we'll see here that the that within the job site facilities specifically, for the 8 tasks that we have for the 1 day apiece, all total to a duration for job site facilities of 8 days. We can directly edit more information here by turning on some of the columns. By right-clicking on the column header here, we show the show hide column window, at which point, if we wanted to, we could choose to assign any of our resources, for instance. We could also make sure that our predecessors column is also displayed, and they could also update the percent complete. Going back to the task list now, we will see this information has been entered here. So now as we step through these individual columns, we'll see that with the predecessors specifically, we can tie specific relationships to these individual tasks. So if we see that, for instance, the floor system materials, for the sake of example here, are going to follow the framing labor task, then we would simply input the task list number 24 as denoted here, or as the task that our floor systems materials should follow. Once we do that, we will notice that there is now an arrow showing the linkage between these two tasks, and we could continue on throughout the rest of this group in the same way. Notice that each time I enter in a predecessor, that relationship is shown with the arrows in the Gantt chart. We can also update our percentage complete. Whenever we enter in any sort of percentage directly into the task here in the task list, we'll notice that that shades in the color of this individual task here. Say if we wanted this one to be 50%, we'll notice that half of that bar has been shaded, whereas 100% is going to shade in that entire task. We'll also notice that once 100% has been reached, we are noted that the task has been completed here, and we can move on to the next task. We also have the ability to assign resources to our individual tasks here by simply clicking within the column, within the cell of the task that you want to assign a resource to. That will bring up the resources window here, where we can go ahead and add a new contact. That's going to bring up our select resources window, at which point we certainly go through, say we wanted to add Ajax Supply as the resource for this individual, for this wall framing materials task here. Select OK. And by saving, we'll notice that Ajax Supply has now been assigned as a resource to this individual task. Now, if you would like to maybe enter in all this information at one point instead of going through each of the individual columns, by just right-clicking on any task, we can go ahead and select our task information. This is going to bring up the Edit Scheduled Task window, where we can change everything from the subject of the task as well as the start dates, end dates, and the durations, as well as percentage complete, priority status, all here within the task tab of the Edit Scheduled Task window. We could also step through the constraints, notes. We could add in both task notes and field notes, which would be beneficial when generating any of our reports, as well as our resources. We can assign these individual tasks to specific users internally within our system, establish any predecessor relationships, as well as set up any reminders, custom reminders, or any additional custom information that you would like to include with this task, all in one very easy to navigate window. In addition to just the very easy, simple to use edit task window, being able to modify these individual tasks, adding new tasks, adding new groups, we also have ways of tracking baselines. For instance, if we were to go to the project here, we could go ahead and set a new baseline. Maybe we just wanted to call this, July 8th of 2014. Establish this baseline. Then, if our project were to shift up, say, 3 days, we then would be able to go back and notice where our original baseline occurred, saying that all these tasks were to take place in the area denoted by the gray shaded box, the gray outline of a box. And we can see how that relates to where our task currently stands. And then, at which point, after generating a baseline schedule report, we can actually see specifically what our variance was as far as the original start date and what we actually ended up doing by the end of the project. This is going to allow you to really kind of keep track of the full status of the schedule, making sure that everybody's kept up to speed as far as the status of the project, keeping everybody on the same page. Once these baseline schedules reports are done, the schedule has been completed. We then could go ahead and share this project, either by exporting the schedule out as a PDF to be able to be printed out by either your client, maybe a subcontractor, anyone like that. But even easier to do is just to go ahead and publish this directly to Construction Online. Doing so is going to create a full, live, editable schedule directly on Construction Online that you can either then share with your clients, subcontractors, or any additional pro users that you also may have within your system. Making sure that you're able to fully utilize ConstructionSuite's on-plan scheduling is really going to help you keep the job on track, make sure that everybody is on the same page, and that the job is completed in a very timely and efficient manner. Well, that concludes today's Suite Talk. If you like what you saw, I encourage you to take a look at some of the other videos that we have available to you. As always, this has been Thanks for tuning in, and have a great day.